What up, YouTube? You can't stop trading and investing with your boy, James E. Tuesday, man. Took my second red day in a row. Been a while. Been a couple months since I've had two red days in a row. Did a lot of day trading today. Hopped back in the Nasdaq. Nasdaq faked me out. A couple trades I was up on and let outside noise influence my decision. And I wound up going green to red. I want to get into all that, but before I do, man, please click that like button. Please subscribe. It is very much appreciated. I am not a financial advisor. I'm just a guy that likes to research and analyze anything I find interesting in the stock market, and I like to share that with anybody willing to listen. So, that being said, let's just get right into this, all right? So, we got a lot going on, man. Let's see. Where could I start? Where was my overnight? My overnight was GVSI. GVSI didn't work out the way I wanted it to. Closed here, gapped up a little bit, but it didn't execute me. And it just wound up tanking. And then I tried trading this thing a couple times, trying to capture this bounce, but it just didn't work out. And then took a very small loss, $112 loss. No big deal. So I said, okay. And then I seen RGBP. And then this thing was kind of crazy, man, because I was up. So this is a play I was in. I dip bought it. And at this point right here, I was up about $800 on my position. And again, man, there's a reason why I trade solo. There's a reason why I've never been in chat rooms. There's a reason why I don't like looking what other people are doing. Because just me personally, psychologically, studying trading psychology, that I have a habit of, if, you know, whether I'm looking at news catalysts, whether I listen to a major guru or, you know, another trader that I just admire, yada, yada, yada. Anytime I come up with a thesis, and typically now if I'm up $800 on a dip buy, I usually sell that thing. I would have probably sold it in the $500-$600 range. I got hit up, and I kind of let news influence me on RGBP. I heard that they were getting acquired. I just so happened to get that news while I was in the middle of my position. So I was thinking we could test this resistance level right here. I was like, okay, cool. We might be able to hit that 275. So I'm just going to hold it. And when it was down here, it was a smart decision because then it started running. And I was like, cool, man. So I just kept piling on shares. I think I got up to like 600 shares or something, just trying to get greedy. At one point, I was up about $800. Then it dropped. Then I was down. Then it popped where I was up about 500. Still didn't take it. And then the thing just cracked on me, crack, and winded up being down about $700, a little over $700. And then I started playing it towards the end of day. When I noticed this curl, started buying it up in here in the 2.3s, popped, sold it into that pop, made $200 back. And then when it dipped again, started buying up 100 shares at a time, bought up 500,000 shares for an overnighter. Because it is first green day, if you look over here, RGBP, it is first green day, and it having this nice curl action and maintaining, looking like it's going to form a cup and handle. As you can see, it's making this cup and then now the handle. So I'm kind of anticipating it to gap up tomorrow. But again, man, this trade, I was up $800 and I could have took that profit, but let the outside news influence my decision because I got the news when I was in the middle of the trade. And I allowed it to influence my decision when normally I would have just took that $500, $600, $700, $800 easy, no problem on a dip buy. But I allowed outside news to influence my decision, and it wound up costing me $459 on the day. You can't see it because my face is there, so I'll just do it here. As you can see, P&L on the day, $459. And took that L, went from red to green, went up 800 to finishing the day minus 459. So that's a total of well over $500 loss. And then, this is my account that I'm over the PDT rule. If you guys watch my previous videos, if you haven't, please go and do so. I've been struggling, dipping in and out of the PDT rule, up and over, you know, over 25K, down 20, below 25K, yada, yada, yada. So I told myself, I said, man, I'm gonna at least build this to 30. To 30K before I start testing Nasdaqs again. So I built this account to 32,000. So I said, okay, I can test this Nasdaq. And then again, Nasdaq faked me out, man. Like, my thesis was correct. So if we look in here, you know, I started seeing this grind action, man. And you know, when it comes to technical analysis, my thesis is usually correct. But with the Nasdaqs, it's a lot harder than OTCs, man, because they're so volatile. And they're just up and down, extreme swings, man. And it winded up getting me, man. I was in and out this four different times. As I was getting in it in here in the 17s when I was seeing it grind. And I bought it on this dip. And it popped up and I took my first, actually it was right here, pulled back, bought it, took this, took like a $60 profit, something like that. Pulled back right here, bought back in, popped, and then dropped. And took a loss and then grinded back up again, got back in again, dropped again, took a loss. You know, and I just kept taking losses, buying it in the 17s, and then look, it ran up to the 22s. So my thesis was correct, but it's just super choppy, man. And I'm trying to get used to capturing the move in the Nasdaq. And, you know, that cost me $909 because Nasdaqs, I have so much data collected on Nasdaqs over the years. But it was just too volatile for me. And then under the PDT rule, I would always take the loss and then I'm not able to get back in. And I almost got back in here in the 960s when it broke this high here and it was holding right here. But I winded up leaving. I said, you know what? I'm already down, you know, close to $2,000 on the day. I'm just going to walk away. I think I was down $2,000. And then I was like, man, I was very tempted to buy it, in here, in this right here. When it broke here and it was holding, I was very tempted to buy it. But again, man, with these, I was waiting for a drop. Because if you look at the actual day, every time we made a new high, dropped. Came right here, then broke new high, then dropped again. And then broke new high here, then dropped again. So when it popped here and broke new highs, I was expecting some kind of drop again. And it didn't happen, and I almost bought it, but right in this area, I was like, man, you know what? I'm going to go out for breakfast and get away from my computer because I'm already down. And then look, pop to the 22s. So, you know, just, you know, it happens, man. It's the name of the game. It's, you know, I made a decision to not trade it just to get away because I'm already down. You know, I could have very well bought it and made a little bit more money back. But it is what it is, man. So took a $900 loss there. Again, man, sometimes I just trade too much. And I notice I got that habit too. Thought I could dip by this when it dropped here. Popped up here, got into it. And then it started dropping and then popped again. And I said, you know what? This isn't going to work. And I just sold it for a $53 loss or whatever. So yeah, man, that, let's see, 1, 2, RETC, RGBP, when it got into that one, GVSI, talked about that one, TIRX, talked about that one, yep, so that was it for this account, and then DSCR, winded up buying, 400,000 shares towards the market close here, because it's still maintaining near the high. I mean, look at it. We're still maintaining, man. And so, you know, if you notice this run, gapped up, boom, dropped, then gapped up again, then dropped, then ran 2 days, pulled back, popped up again, then dropped. And then now, if you look at the 5-day, 5-minute chart, as you can see, it's kind of grinding back up there. So we're having this, you know, this up, down, roller coaster type, you know, pattern. And it's looking solid where it was going to pop. So we may potentially get a gap up on it. That would be nice. So I bought 400,000 shares here and I believe 300,000 shares in another account. 300,000 shares here. So overall winded up minus 119 for that overnight play, to go into the next day because one, A, it's holding near the highs. Two, it does have a tendency to gap up after red days. And three, you know, it has that nice roller coaster pattern looking like it's about to pop again. So I say, you know what? This one looks like it could potentially go. So I got an overnight play on that. And then an overnight play on RGBP. You know, again, got back some of my profits. I was down a total of 700, but just sloppy trading, man, because realistically, I could have been green on the day if I'd have just sold RGBP, you know, right here into this pop, and I was up $800, which would have put me up $700 for the day, and I probably would have never even traded the Nasdaq, or, you know, I would have waited till end of day for the rest of it to play out, and I could have walked away green, but, you know, it is what it is, man. Sometimes, you know, I want to try new things, so the Nasdaq, I'm trying to get used to their volatility, and then all the other plays that I took, you know, I was just trying to capture something that I thought was there, and it just didn't work out, and that also happens. So, you know, got 500,000 shares of RGBP going into tomorrow, and then got 700,000 shares of DSCR going into tomorrow. So that's going to be it for today, guys. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think of my analysis. Again, if you made it this far, please click that like button. Please subscribe. You can't stop mafia. It's a mindset movement, meaning never stop yourself, never stop your progress, never stop your education, especially in finance. Having multiple streams of income is an amazing thing, and the stock market is a place where you can do that. So two red days in a row to start off this week. Man, that hasn't happened for a while, but it's part of the game. Down a little over $2,000 on the day. So that put me in the hole for the week, a little over $3,000. That is still less than what I made on Friday. Put it in a proper perspective, man. So that's going to be it for today, man. I'll be sure to keep you updated as much as possible. Till next time, I'm out. Peace.